It's Levack and Goz on 104.5 The Team.
Yeah, we're live. We're getting ready. It's, what, 2 hours away from finding out who you actually work for. Chris Thompson, Director of Football Operations, and then during the season, Offensive Coordinator. But Director of Football Operations doesn't stop, right? Just because you're drawing up X's and O's?
Pretty much, yeah.
So yes. what at the arena level, what is Director of Football Operations? What are you, on a day-to-day, what are you doing?
So one of my main objectives is the youth Football Academy that we've just launched recently, earlier this week, for kids ages 6 through 12. And we basically put on some skills clinics or sessions throughout our season with our players and coaches and kind of teach them or do some drills within the fundamentals of the game of football, not just arena football, but just football in general.
See, that's smart, because then when they get older, they're going to play for you.
Correct. And, you know, it's a very intimate setting where they're going to get a chance to work with our players and our coaches, and it's our chance to get involved in the community and give back and teach them fundamentals of this great game.
So that, now plus the offensive coordinator side of it, during the game, are you going to be the play caller? Is Coach Keefe going to be calling plays? Depending on the flow, what's going to happen there?
As far as I'm aware, I will be calling plays. But obviously, you know, Coach Keefe is the head coach, and if there's certain things that he wants or he's going to, you know, he has the right to make those decisions. So I'm going to follow his lead, and I'm very excited for the opportunity.
Chris Thompson with us right now, Director of Football Operations, OC for the Albany football team. I asked Coach Les Moss, have you ever seen a situation where you've got a fan base and they don't even know who the hell you are yet?
it's funny. I was up last week and had a bunch of appointments because we're working on housing and things like that, and food deals and things of that nature. And everybody's asking, so did you guys name your team? No, in time, next week, this, yep. And it's here. So it's awesome. It's very exciting. Excited to finally unveil it and to our fans and our partners and to the rest of the arena football world.
So what's your timeline now? Now, we found out the team name today. You guys got the tryouts in the weekend, and then what happens after you guys in full gear for season mode after that?
Yeah, so obviously it's going to be a big, starting Saturday is picking our roster, and that has all started. Obviously we've had conversations as a coaching staff on some guys we want to target. Coach Moss and Coach Keefe have a long history of coaching in the Arena Football League. This is my first opportunity, and so I'm very humbled for it and excited for it, and excited to learn from them, because those are some great ones and have won Arena Bowl championships. And so it doesn't stop. Obviously putting a playbook together, recruiting, going through scheduling for our camp when it can start. And all that fun stuff. So there's a lot that goes into it.
Coach, this is you beginning with arena, but you're no stranger to football. 6 years with Lehigh Valley?
Correct, yep.
Wait a minute. Are you an Eagles fan?
Yes, I am.
All right, let's cover the machinery. Let's keep everything safe. Yeah.
I am born and raised Pennsylvania. So Philadelphia, not far from Philadelphia native, and Philly sports fan most of my life. So it's exciting to see that the Eagles, get a third shot to the Super Bowl, and hopefully it's the third time's a charm.
Have you ever fought a police horse?
I have not. And do not plan to anytime soon either.
You call yourself a fan. One of the coaches here for the Albany Arena Football League.
Yeah, now you with the coach mindset, you look at this Eagle team, you think, they're doing it with a backup quarterback. How is Doug Peterson doing this with Philadelphia?
I love it, because it's about team, and this sport and this game is the ultimate team sport, and it's a perfect example. It starts at the top, Jeffrey Lurie down to the coaching staff, the front office staff, and then ultimately down to the players. And, what an awesome job they've done, it's exciting. And it's the culture that they have in place, the system that they have in place. And we use for years of saying next man up. Somebody goes down, next man up, and they've been able to fulfill that motto. So Nick Foles has done an outstanding job, as well as a number of other players that they've lost, unfortunately this season.
Right. It's been a crazy year. Now everybody, it's you're a fan, so you've seen it. Everybody has a plan on how to beat Tom Brady. Like, but as the offensive coordinator, do you watch that Patriots defense and go, oh, you got to run more screens, or oh, do you, do you does it ever turn off, or like when you're watching, are you now preparing like, look, if I was calling the plays, we'd be doing this.
Yeah, it's, I mean, always. I mean, that the mindset never changes. You know, being a, you know, football coach, you always, you know, analyzing or critiquing, and it's just like a fan, you know. But you know, you try to put yourself in that situation, you know, and you know, it's that part of it's exciting, you know. And but those, I mean, Tom Brady, you know, arguably the best to ever play the game, you know.
Right.
You know, and Joe Montana is up there, you know, people name him, John Elway, you know, others. So it's
Ron Jaworski.
Yeah. I mean, there's what a task. But if there's ever a team that could do it, I think the Eagles this year can do it. So.
In two weekends, we're going to watch the Eagles play the Patriots. But this upcoming weekend is the open tryouts. I asked Coach Moss this question. He said he wants ballers. That's what he's looking for. But yeah. Now, you're the OC. What are you looking for at the open tryout?
Well, same thing. I mean, we're looking for guys, you know, the diamond in the rough. You know, guys that can play the game. You know, we're looking for guys that, you know, guys that play top-notch college football. You know, all Americans, all conference guys, all league guys, you know, that maybe were on the draft boards of NFL teams but maybe didn't get drafted, or maybe slipped through the cracks. Maybe they were in camp with NFL teams and they're just trying to get back, because it's, you know, look at it, 32 teams, 53-man rosters. I mean, do the math. There's not many guys playing professional football. So these guys have that opportunity to come play for us and be one of the 24 that we're going to keep for our season. So it's we're infancy stage of building that roster, and these guys, you know, been in the league and been winners, and so it's very exciting.
Now, Coach, you're the offensive coordinator, and as a Capital Region homer, been here my whole life, I have to just kind of point out Wade Hansen and Jordan Canzeri. I mean, those two are the two names that I know locals are all going, these guys, They got to make it.
Yep.
So when guys like that who have, played at major college programs the whole nine, they come out, do they have to do the same stuff as everybody else?
Or yes. Maybe they,
really?
Yes.
Come on.
Absolutely.
I was going to pretend I had a pedigree. Trying to skip the running. I might have come out.
Look, obviously, we already know of Wade and Jordan. You know, we've watched college film of them. Jordan at Iowa, he had a great career. Wade at Virginia Tech, you know, so we're familiar with those guys, you know. They fit the bill of some of the attributes that we're looking for, you know. But now they got to learn the game of arena football, you know, 50-yard
right.
field, you know, by 28 yards wide. So it's different. The windows are smaller. The game is faster. And it's, you know, people don't realize that these are top-notch athletes playing arena football. And the speed, the scoring, that wall doesn't move that these guys get hit into.
No.
So from that standpoint, it's very exciting being in person watching it.
With no disrespect to Wade or Jordan, I thought you were going to go somewhere else with that question. I thought as a Capital Region longtime fan, you were going to ask if touchdown Eddie Brown can still play. And I don't know the answer to that. Can Antonio Brown play? Are you going to sign any of the Brown family? I don't know.
If there's any others out there, we'll definitely be interested. I mean, look, Antonio is arguably the best wide receiver in the National Football League. Eddie Brown is one of the best, if not the best, all-time Arena Football League wide receiver. So what an awesome pedigree, and those are the type of guys that we're looking for to come play here and be a part of our franchise.
Now, look, if I was going to be a real homer, South Colony kid.
Oh, my goodness.
I'd bring up the 1998 Ironman, Chad Dukes. That's who I would bring up. And his brother Chucky, who probably still are in phenomenal shape compared to me. That's if I was going to go homer, that's where I would go. Coach, we appreciate making some time. We're very excited. And the energy that you and Coach Keefe and Coach Moss, it's amazing. And we're excited. It's infectious. And just can't wait to know what team we're cheering for. So we're looking forward to tonight, 6 o'clock. We're going to have the announcement live on the air.
Yep, awesome. We can't either.
Coach, thanks so much for making time. It's Levack and Goz. We're live from the Palace Theater. And we just keep right on rolling talking about the AFL. And then sooner or later, we're going to know who we're talking about.